Now let's start with the topic of centrifugal pumps. Before we talk about the centrifugal pumps, we need to understand what are pumps. Well, pumps is a pump is a hydraulic device or a hydraulic machinery which converts the mechanical energy into hydraulic energy. Now this hydraulic energy is in the form of the pressure energy. Okay, and if this conversion from mechanical energy to the pressure energy or the hydraulic energy is done with the help of a centrifugal force or centrifugal effect, okay, then the pump which is being used to do this conversion is called a centrifugal pump. Okay, so in a simpler way, I would say that centrifugal pump is a pump which converts the mechanical energy with the help of the centrifugal effect into the pressure energy. In more simpler ways, if you remember the radial turbines, this is nothing but a reversed inward radial flow turbine. Reversed, not the actual one, because turbine is a energy producing device, pump is an energy consuming device. So this would be a reversed inward flow, or I would say inward radial flow turbine. Alright. So you can look at a centrifugal pump in this fashion as well. Alright, so this is a basic schematic of a centrifugal pump. The main components of a centrifugal pump are that you have an impeller, which is somewhat like the runner in the turbines. Alright, so impeller is connected to the prime mover, which rotates it, gives it mechanical energy. Okay, and then you have a suction pipe which goes down the sump where the liquid is there, which is to be pumped to a higher head. This is the foot valve and the strainer, which separates all the impurities or hard particles to be entrapped inside these moving parts of the pump. Alright, so this acts as a filter. Then this is the sump, the liquid rises up the suction pipe, enters the impeller eye. So this part is called the eye of the impeller, and this is where the suction happens, or the inlet is there for the liquid in a centrifugal pump. Then it rotates, comes out, collects in this casing. This is called the spiral or the volute casing, and from this volute casing it comes out and goes out like this into the discharge pipe. So this is the discharge pipe. Alright, now you have a valve over here. This can be called the outlet valve to control the discharge. Okay, so this is the discharge valve. We have not shown an inlet valve, so you need to show some inlet valve as well. So let us say this is the inlet valve. It controls the inward flow of the liquid into the impeller eye. Okay, so in a very simplistic manner, you have suction pipe, impeller, volute casing and a discharge pipe as the main parts of a centrifugal pump. Okay, then there are many parts. You have this inlet valve, discharge valve. Okay, there are many parts to it, but for in a very simplistic manner, these are your main parts. Now, if you look at this level, from this level, let us say to this level, this is the total head by which the liquid has to be raised. Till the center of the eye, this is the suction head. And from the center of the eye to the point of the delivery, or the highest point of the delivery, you have the discharge head. Okay, so this becomes the suction head. HD becomes the delivery head. Okay, and the total head is equal to the suction head plus delivery head. Okay, so this is a very basic introduction to the concept of centrifugal pumps. I hope you have understood this. Now, let's move on to the next video and talk about the work done by the impeller onto the water, because we will be dealing with water which is being handled by a centrifugal pump. So let's talk about that in the next video.